There's only 151 Pokemon and like 12 missing those or something. I don't remember.
Actually, other question, seeing as we're talking about Souls-likes.
What?
For Honor.
Whoa!
What?
Are you getting this?
No?
Oh, I don't have walls.
Oh.
Most of the level hasn't loaded. I see all the fires on the houses everywhere, and I can see that one. I can see a yokai patrolling around, like 50 feet in front of us. There's like half the levels out here.
Do I have to seeing eye wander for you?
Like, you just shot a guy that was floating in the air between two tall ladders. There's nothing besides the ladders over there. Holy crap.
Is it still a problem for you?
It's popping in. No! Oh, whoa, whoa. This structure wasn't here for me a second ago. Oh, the bamboo structure there. Aw. Aw, it fixed itself.
Alright, well that's good.
I wanted it to be broken the whole time. That would have been an experience.
That would have actually been kind of weird and interesting.
I would just have an invisible level where all I see is the geometry of the ground.
That would have been a problem. So, have you looked into For Honor at all, or know anything about it?
I know it exists, and it's a multiplayer Ubisoft game.
Fair point.
Where that people compare to Dark Souls. And, like, I have no history of covering multiplayer arena games.
Yeah, that's my problem. It's like, I don't know if there's a campaign mode, because that's what I'd be interested in. Ow.
I'm not generally interested in making videos of, like, this is me fighting randoms on the internet in some game. Like, I don't...
If it goes cheap enough, I'd definitely get together with, like, our group and play it. I think that would be enjoyable.
That's just a whole part of video games I haven't actively engaged in since 2004.
Well, my issue is, like, that market is such an inconsistent one that it's hard to like, really want to get into it. Because... Like, from my perspective, I know, like, Call of Duty channels are pretty much dead now, and it's just like, I don't want to get attached to a competitive multiplayer game, because I think I would,
it would
go poorly for me.
I don't really care how well it would do, necessarily, it's just I don't know if I care about the game.
Well, yeah, it's also a very repetitive experience, which I guess is the case of this, too.
Like, I played the crap out of Halo 2, and that was the last online multiplayer game I played for any real amount of time. You tried to do this? Oh, it went all over the place.
Tried to do what was that, Keith? I'm sorry, I missed it. Oh, you can't do down attacks on these guys. Ow.
No, you just hit him a lot. Oop. Charge me? Nope.
Well, he's dead.
These guys are a little tricksy just because their basic movement is an attack.
I had the hardest time actually fighting them initially because the first one I killed died in, like, no time or effort. Whereas, like, The third one, I think it was, died, like, really took some effort to kill and did, like, a ton of damage to me, and it was just such a surprise.
I just realized that you can dodge while aiming.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
You'll be aiming at a guy, and you see him shoot at you, and you're like, boom, and you just dash away and try again.
Oh, that was a lot of damage.
The whole aiming thing.
Ah, no.
I believe in you. You can do it, Wander.
I keep diving into the fire rolling away from this guy, because that...
You can do it.
Ow.
Just did a really awkward slap against the wall to kill him.
Hey, it works.
Killed him with one of those awkward swings that reflects off the wall. That's great.
But yeah, also Ubisoft, anything Ubisoft is like, for me.
Yeah, they've been kings of making anything interesting sounding as boring as possible for the last 5 years.
Yeah.
That doesn't help a lot. That was one of those assholes that actually played the Assassin's Creed games consistently. And they sapped old soul out of that franchise as best they could.
Yep.
Fall down too. Oh, he didn't. Damn it, he rolled off. He rolled away from falling off the ledge. He knows the trick. Whoa!
Yeah. Whoa. I got killed by that by an invader, which was a bit of a surprise.
The hell of a surprise. that's in his inventory.
That was interesting teleportation nonsense.
Get off the ledge! Get off the ledge! See, even he rolls off. I think it just works forever as long as you aren't out of stamina. Roll off of any ledge falls.
Ow. This guy is not cool.
Oh.
And now dead.
Well, him on a trip.
All right.
Went horizontal off that ledge.
Yeah. I'm also, like, super leery of anything that requires Uplay, because Uplay is a,
Oh, right! On PC, you have to install bullshit. I forgot.
Yep. Ah! Whoa! Whoa! Yeah. I didn't see him until his face...
I didn't see him
until his face was on my screen. And then things got really, really weird looking.
The silly thing with that guy, Wander, that yokai you're aiming at, is you can just lure him to that hole right in front of him and he'll fall in it. One on the roof.
I know.
Great.
Or I can shoot him in the face a bunch. You didn't really like it when that happens.
Look at our wheel friend down here, Wander. Take a look at the guy. Doing interesting things. Oh, wow, I found the exact barrier where his animation breaks down. Here it's normal speed. Here it goes low frame rate. Here it's normal speed. Here it's low frame rate.
Oh, wow, that is...
You can see the exact boundary. I assume you're in the frame rate mode, where your stabilizes your frame rate, because of course that's the better option.
Can I get a leak spin? Because this is pretty leak spin.
I love that that's when it changes speed, like right on that barrier. Great.
Oh, I have to get
I know, little... just the solution. Oh.
Hey, you got him! You did fire damage him, to him.
I didn't aim for him, though. I aimed for the wheel and it blew up in front of me on that. I guess it always blows up horizontal to you. And it doesn't go down and hit things. Apparently. Quick, while he's fallen! Haha! Oh. Oh, Skellington Man. No.
Ow.
Oh, hitting the wall.
I should
Pro
probably
status
take
right
these
there.
Guys a little bit more seriously. I should probably... I should probably take
these ridiculous bombs.
How many of those do you get? Only like two?
Like three and five?
I got bad
news,
Keith.
And I get one of the big ones?
He dropped cool shit.
For you? Maybe? I got white, yellow.
Alright, I got a purple.
You're trying a living weapon through it?
Got
it. Last?
Got it.
Oh my god.
Just barely. But I got
it. You're still on fire, right?
Yeah. I'm just like 8 damage a pop. Here, there's a shrine back here that I kind of want to get.
Oh, they put a shrine back here in this level?
Yeah, it's like a secret back shrine.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I throw away all my armor dead anyway. Bye. It does give our assist gauge. That's the important thing.
Well, it gives our assist gauge, but it does give us an Amrita bonus.
Well, yeah, but I was just saying that I don't care about that because I'm throwing it away, though.
Oh, I care about it.
I was like, but it does refill our meter.
I've just been pumping as many points into my stamina gauge as I can because I want to wear the Nioh armor because it looks cool.
Yeah. We're doing the same characters for co-op and multiplayer.
Yeah, you don't want
to get rid of all the bonus experience so it doesn't overreflate my single-player character in any way.
Yep.
Because pumping points into even less important stats will still mean that it's really hard
extra
to level up the important stats.
Yeah, that's true.
So, wait, no, just so no, come back here.
Okay.
Do this because it's fun.
Yeah,
hey,
I tried getting him to go into the hole. It didn't work.
It's worked every time for me.
Here, I'll let you drop the ladder.
There he
shortly.
Goes. Oh, you're in there.
Yeah, it's okay.
That's not. Not how the strategy works.
I fell down, you pushed me, when you were like going around, you kind of like pushed me a little bit. Can you drop the ladder for me?
If only I just dropped you directly into the fire.
Well, you did actually, it hurt.
Oh.
But like, only barely. I've got enough HP that it's not like too big of a deal whenever
I'll loot
I get
everything
set on
down
fire.
Here.
Let's see. Do they even need any more flaming wheels at this point? I have no idea.
Are there any big cost things in this game?
Ow.
I wonder.
Oop.
I haven't paid much attention yet to what gold is used for.
Reforging your weapons.
Does crafting just get way expensive later or something?
Oh, yeah. It costs...
Okay,
because
like, I have
bring...
like hundreds of grands, and that's
if
weird.
I
want to
bring my, chest...
He was not on you.
If I want to bring my chest piece... Ow, come on. If I want to bring my chest piece up to level, you got a gun aimed at you. What? No? He shot me? That's really odd. Yeah, if I want to bring my chest piece up to level 25, yeah, he did. It's going to cost me like 150. It's going to cost me 150 grand to update my chest piece, which sucks. So crafting is generally way better. Yeah.
Money does do a thing.
Yep. I still dig it though. Oh, right. I forgot about the burning heads.
Oh, not a one-shot kill. Nope. Oh, right. I use guns for one-shot kills. There we go. Cool. Doing wonders for my elixir backlog, I think.
I'm having a harder time telling because I am taking a lot of damage here, but I think it's still less than if I'd played solo.
But I also keep the bonus elixirs thing equipped.
Oh.
The blessing.
I think I went with bonus Amrita, because I don't know. I want to wear that Nioh armor.
I want as many elixirs as possible, so whenever I go to the back of the shrine, it's replenishing the max amount.
I should see how many I've got. Well, I'm done.
That seems super risky, by the way, that they this spawn where you kill him.
Yes. Oh, yeah. I feel like
playing with fire, the like level-ending thing would spawn like off the level, depending on what goes on.
Let's see. The interesting thing is actually once you spawn the end of the level thing, you become invulnerable. Like, completely invulnerable, and you can explore the level that you were just in without taking a single point of damage. So I've used that to actually go around.
That's weird.
And loot all the treasure that I missed in the past for the last, like, secret mission or a side mission.
That's really strange. So you can't take damage?
Yeah, I was walking through
probably
fire.
Probably because it was originally designed as an exit from boss chambers where there wouldn't be anything to fight anyway.
Yeah, exactly. But
then they probably retroactively tried to jam in a bunch of side quests after the game was kind of designed at that point.
Yeah, just to pad things out.
Yeah. Huh. That's really weird.
Yep. I was really weird. Very confused when I found that out because it was the last side mission on this region. And yeah, I was able to just walk through fire, poisons, take no falling damage. Also, all enemies despawn if there were any left. So,
oh.
Yeah.
Well, that nullifies a lot of it then.
It does. Yes.
I thought you meant you were running around fighting people with while invincible, and I'm like, that's a weird thing for the game.
No,
to let you
but
do.
Like, there were a lot of traps. Like the entire point of the area is that it was covered in traps, and they did not matter. Alright, I'm good.
I was mass disassembling a bunch of low-level items because, everything just fills up. Hamming that X button! Alright.
If it turns out For Honor actually has,
preparations
like,
complete. There we go.
Campaign mode, I'll probably bug you about it because that shit would be fun. But the actual competitive, meh.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see if they, I was almost going to say, like, of course, I was almost going to take it for granted that they would add a campaign because of how much it seemed to blow up in the face of Titanfall not having a campaign, but
yeah.
I don't think Rainbow Six Siege has a campaign, and that's the same company.
Yeah, I don't know if it does. That's an interesting question. I don't know.
I think that's purely an online multiplayer, like, versus game, and that's it, but I could be wrong. It's really the only part people talk about.
This mission threw me for such a loop when...
What am I wearing on my head right now?
Tried it.
What?
Ninja headband.
What the heck? I'm like, that's not my tactician. That was not my tactician item.
Okay, question.
I was clearly wearing earlier.
The Kappa here. The Kappa here is the entire goal, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You can touch your touchpad to find the objective of every mission.
Oh! Didn't realize. Well, this is the fastest mission.
We did
mission.
It! That was exciting.
Yeah.
did it. We got the Hisebe. Oh no, what have we done?
let's fight this thing. Actually, it looks... No, no, no. There's a second.
What?
There's a second Kappa in the corner.
Oh, that was a spawned one. Weird.
Yeah. Or, it like, a weird co-op thing? Maybe you have to...
Game seems to completely ignore co-op on a mechanical level.
Where did you go? What are you doing?
Just hanging out. I was looking for the Kappa. Where'd it go? Oh,
he's around a corner.
Go on, buddy. He's a dick, because he goes charging into every single spawn if he can. Where did he go?
He's, like, around a corner. I saw a bit of his shell while I was fighting this sucker.
Oh, there's a Kappa at the top of the, ladder
yeah,
to the shrine over there.
I think there might be multiple now. Either they updated the game or something.
Or we both got lucky and got the right one first.
I never saw any other ones. Oh yeah, there he is. Yeah, I think that might have been the one.
Weird.
I saw. Did you take out everybody else down here?
Nope, I shot one dude that was up at the ladder.
Oh.
About it. He's a dick, too. Chasing the cop around and he keeps stunning you mid-combo and everything and... blocking and blocking and blocking and stuff.
I was doing low stance Kusari Gama, which actually messes him up pretty bad.
Good. Bats. Oh.
Does it keep going up?
Oh crap.
It does.
What keep going up?
I didn't know if you could keep going up this level.
Oh, the shrine location. Skeleton guy, watch out. Oh, here it comes.
The big one?
On fire. Might be? I can't get a good sense of scale from here. Whoa!
Oh, that's not a skeleton guy. This is a regular dude.
I can't tell from behind. Big guy in armor and a weapon, they look the same from behind.
Yeah, I'm getting tons of elixirs. I should have switched back to this. Yeah, that's one of my complaints about this game. Yeah, this level actually just keeps going on. I didn't realize that. Where are you?
That bomb takes a while to throw. Going around my fireworks, basically.
Oh.
A lot of enemies throughout the level. Huh.
Damn. Oh,
I thought
died.
It was going to be over more immediately.
I died.
Did you fall or something?
I tried leap striking the.
Oh, there you are.
Kappa. Well.
Oh.
I will not try and do that again.
They put a chest up here.
Oh, neat. Yeah, I didn't even know you could go all the way up here. Well,
yeah.
The Kappa is running around somewhere down below.
It ends right there, though.
Yeah.
Oh, he's at the bottom of the. Yeah, I see him.
Yeah, I tried leap striking him and I missed. He, like, rolled out of the way.
Thankfully, there's a path straight down.
Yep. Any of the other side paths? Passages work? Oh yeah, you took this way up. Wow! All of these are elixirs. Well, if I was low before, now I'm not. Damn.
Do you know the shortcut path down?
The one through the cave with the bats or something else?
Nah, the, you know where you fight the big, where there's normally a big axe skeleton guy?
Yeah.
Or whatever? You can just jump on, like, that big stalagmite sticking out of the ground
there.
Yeah. You just jump on that.
I know about that. But, like, I don't...
You're an annoying little shit. Come here.
I don't generally take shortcuts in these, because there's usually a better shortcut that makes a lot more sense given the situation.
There he was. So that was the right one.
Yep.
Interesting.
Okay.
Yeah, well, it definitely didn't happen last time.
Yeah, I was not expecting there to be two Kappas.
Imagine your Twitch audience is...
Let's see.
...interpreting that word differently.
Somebody's wondering if you're streaming this as well. No, Keith doesn't like streaming.
Acknowledge me! Acknowledge me!
I had a weird interaction today where I was talking about, like, doing this with you, and somebody was like, who's that guy again? Is that the one that you do the podcast with? And I'm just like, that's odd.
Yeah.
Alright, Kanban the Overlord? Oh, right, this is the one. Oh, this is the hard one, sort of. Hard-ish.
No matter how many years we do videos together, people will always be confused by either of us showing up in the other one's videos. I want more of the strategist set. I probably can just craft the whole thing. Crafting feels weird when I'm just gonna out-level it, like, immediately.
Yeah, my problem with crafting is, you do a couple levels and you're just past it in terms of, like...
Yeah.
Level quality, and it's just like, So at some point, like, I'm probably just gonna...
Why did I do that?
Yeah. If raising your item's level wasn't so expensive, I'd be super down, but...
Crafting in general, and leveling in general, kind of feels weird sometimes, where... You get the super duper crazy super weapon, congratulations! And like two levels later, you're like, now there's a better one! You got it on the ground.
Yeah, at first I was pretty okay with the just random gear system in this game, but the fact that it's... If I could just...
You did this big quest, you get the Heshikiri Hasebe!
Yeah.
Now here's a second one that's better.
Yeah. I guess for me, I would rather it have, like, kind of the Dark Souls thing where it's, like, you make the item and then you can just kind of keep improving it so it's always, like, good as opposed to, like, cycling it out randomly. Because there's so many,
like... A nice,
like,
regular upgrade to it.
Yeah. So, like, I'd be super down for, getting a bunch of trash items that I just turn into crafting components and or occasionally drag, you know, my Kusari Gama up to the appropriate level. But instead, it's...
Something that inevitably happens to me in this kind of game is that I'm constantly aware of how much leveling up my weapon doesn't seem like a good idea because of how soon I'll level it up. I mean, I'll out-level it. But then, before long, I'm like, I beat the game and I never found the part where I should start caring about the crafting. Oh no. Like,
yeah.
I guess I should have started doing it at some point, because putting it off for later doesn't matter. It doesn't work if you never do it.
Yeah, see, I wish things would just... like, kind of smoothly let you scale your weapons up, no matter what. Do I have, like, a kick or something that I can do to break his guard? I guess that works.
There you did it! Yay. Congratulations.
Alright, I'm gonna switch back to the Kusari Gama. For fighting these guys, it's kind of a pain in the butt.
I want to get the full strategist set. I want to get a set bonus out of it. I don't even know if it's even good.
It's good.
In fact, it gives you treasure sense, enemy sense, 5% close combat damage, 15% close combat key damage. Not bad. Look like a dishwasher.
Yeah, it actually gives more armor, I think, than, like, the Nioh set. Maybe? I don't know. It was hard
to compare, because you'd have to have the exact same items at the exact same level to actually know... compare the two.
It was bizarre when I was looking at it, because it...
Oh, I just had the realization. What the hell does a wiki look like for these items?
Oh.
How do you even try to quantify the stats of some of these items?
No, there's
like a standardized
totally,
level to compare them all?
There's totally, like, a standardized multiplier comparatively. So, like, you do it, like, at level 50 or at level 100. Pokemon does this, too. With, like, at level X, this item's going to be this good. I'm summoning so many of these guys.
Why though?
Why not?
Why though?
Do you just hate fun?
No, I'm going into unarmed now. Punch, punch, punch. I got you. You can't handle the pressure. Love it. Oh, wow. Yeah, the swing happens so fast it's almost impossible.
Yeah,
to
I just wait for him to
time.
Attack. I just wait for him to attack you and then I trip him.
Oh, damn it. Trying to hit triangle the exact second his animation begins to move, but even then it's like, no.
Okay,
you have to somehow anticipate when he's going to attack, but he's an AI,
actually
so.
Going to kill me.
Got it.
These guys are stupid aggressive in not a good way. At least we're getting a lot
of Revenant Slayer. So apparently, 21... you eventually get a glory vendor.
Ooh, neat.
Summon, watch out. You approach Guitar Man.
I did. I'm also getting barfed on.
Yerf. Wow, even that tiny fragment of health was too much to be destroyed by a punch. Hi there.
Can you put your weapon back on, by the way?
Oh. What, do you hate fun?
This is a hard mission.
Yeah, but not now. It's not hard yet.
Well, the problem
when we get to
the
one
the problem
room
is
and
I'm getting
never
like
before.
I'm getting cornered by these shits.
That was interesting.
Well, okay, there you are.
I went sailing off into space. Well, there was no ledge. There was definitely not a ledge moment.
You did operate as a very good decoy, so I could push the other guy off the ledge.
I saw him follow me down. That was great. Put your weapon back on.
Put it back on. So the problem is, since I'm the one that does
that was it was a joke for the hot spring.
Oh. I wasn't paying attention. Yeah, the problem is, with you not having a weapon, it means that I will hit the enemies once and they'll hate me forever, so they back me into a corner and beat me to death.
Hi.
Can you even disarm these dudes?
Probably not. Oh god, they're both on me. Goody.
Can you put your weapon on? Ow.
Buddy. What are you doing? Oh, I can't disarm your arm. I definitely can't disarm your hand. Oh, crap. That's a hell of a slow wind-up. Important thing is that I'm the best distraction.
Uh-huh.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Poor guy.
That almost went poorly for me. Okay. I'm also curious how fast we can get through all of these. Because, like, can we get through all of the first region more or less in 2 hours? And the answer is very possible.
Probably, yeah. There's not a ton going on if you're not actively exploring and progressing from scratch.
Well,
it's
true.
Like, yep. Knowing what you're doing in a game of this sort of subgenre massively changes the time any of it takes. Like imagine your second playthrough through Dark Souls 2, for example. Like, jeez. I'm already here. It's like the only emotion you have the entire time you're playing through it. It's constantly being baffled by how far you are, and then it's over. Boop. These enemies are really good at exhausting themselves if you just slowly step backwards.
Unfortunately, their stamina always comes back really fast, so it's like...
Yeah! I headshot them through the crate.
At some point, I'd like to go back and suffer through figuring out how to get Dark Souls 1 to function properly. Because I'd love to co-op through that game as well. But, like, the last time Bird and I tried playing it, it was, like, 5 frames a second. Which was really weird. Yeah. It, like,
Red DS fix?
So, whatever they did to get rid of, Games for Windows Live, made it so that it performed really terribly on certain computers.
That's brutal that we can sync up our executions.
Yes. Brutal and super convenient. Okay. I love that boxes actually randomly will have good equipment in them occasionally in this game.
Just to encourage you to Zelda pot smash the entire game.
Yeah. Usually they've got ammo, which to me is just as good. Well.
Welcome to the danger zone.
Yeah. I remember. No, there's not an archer up here. Oh, these guys chuck bombs. Oh, there's more of them, though. Ow, there is an archer up here.
Are there more of them?
Yeah, there's a skeleton with a cannon.
I'm running around in my inventory right now.
You shit.
Working so far. There we go. I was just blind running around with my inventory open. There we go. So I had a... I was like, I want to put my weapon back on. And, forgot I had it sorted by ability.
Oops.
So the chain weapons are on the very bottom of the entire list, so I was slowly scrolling down the whole thing.
It'd be really nice if we could almost, sort by favorite. Or, like, have
or
a favorite
Or equip more
list.
Weapons?
Yeah. Or that, yeah.
I feel like, ow. I feel like more than anywhere this shows up as a result- Ah! What? I didn't dodge that? Alright. It shows up more than anywhere, I think, in the part where the game gives you 3 types of ranged weapons, but only lets you equip 2.
Yes.
And I'm like, why can't I just equip all 3 ranged weapons?
I will admit, I like the
just
Dark Souls
cycle through your hand cannon, your bow, and your cannon.
Though I guess I'm also pretty down with the fact that, Oh, come on, are they both on me? They're both on me.
The interesting thing is that based on when this game started development, it's that matches with the Dark Souls games that existed at the time they were making this game, but modern Dark Souls games let you equip 3 of in both slot.
Yep.
Like it's
if
it
I
almost,
remember right, this
it
thing...
almost shows you how slavishly some of the mechanics of this game are just like it worked for Dark Souls. Let's try that.
If I remember right, though, this game was, like, actually, like, took 10 years to make or something like that.
Nah.
Yeah.
A game called Nioh started 10 years ago, like, way, like, 2004? But that game is not this game.
Okay.
Same property, but it's not the same development in any way, because Team Ninja started working on it in 2014.
Oh. That is...
Yeah. That's very recently.
Less time spent.
Yeah, it completely invalidates those arguments people really desperately try to cling to when they're for some reason really emotional about this not being based in any way on Dark Souls. Like, no, it started in 2004 by completely different people in an unrelated manner. I'm like, yeah, so did Final Fantasy 15. We didn't get that game. That game is not what we got. Whatever 13 Versus started as, for example.
Ow. Are you dead?
Nah, I was just laying down for a very long time. I think he was standing on me.
So after you get hit by that axe, you actually get the option.
Wow, they are all glowing.
The
concerning.
The graves? Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is what
I've been a little worried about that.
Well, one's up.
But yeah, basically some completely different development team worked on this game in 2004. And it was mostly a bunch of proof of concept things and a few other developments. And the lead designer was never satisfied with it and just canceled the project. And then way later, Team Ninja picked up the project and led to this thing. Which makes sense, because Team Ninja's probably in a tough spot where they're trying to figure out what the hell to do with their company.
Yeah, because Ninja Gaiden has kind of been...
Yeah, Ninja Gaiden was poorly received, and their lead guy left.
Oh.
Or was fired, one of those. Itagaki, the guy that leads Team Ninja, that leads the... Ninja Gaiden and Dead or Alive franchises. Like, he's been gone for a while.
Ah. I guess that kind of explains why they haven't done much lately.
Yeah, he went on to make Devil's Third, which is not much to talk about.
Yeah, I was watching Game Grumps play that for a moment, and I was like, the only redeeming point about this entire experience is that they're playing it. Uh-oh.
It's concerning. As to the quality of that guy's ability to work with another team, although
yeah.
Maybe the team sucks.
I remember seeing a quote, actually. I looked it up, and it was just like, this is going to revolutionize the FPS market. And I was just like, what are you smoking?
He was saying it was going to be the most revolutionary, incredible... Like he was like Peter Molyneux times 100 talking about that game.
Oof.
And then you see the game that came out, and you're like, huh.
You know what? Only way I can see that actually working, working out is... him never playing an FPS since, like, Half-Life.
That wouldn't even be true either.
I don't know. It had some things.
Back in back in those days, we had Half-Life, and we had Doom, and we had System Shock 2, and we had all these other franchises that Devil's Third could not compete with.
Oh, yeah, in terms of, like, sheer quality, but, like, mechanically, technically, you could claim that Devil's Third has a leg up on, like... good old Half-Life 1.
Or I don't know.
Graphically.
That thing's... because that game's a nightmare.
Yeah.
Well, that's cheat. Graphics is just cheating, though.
Yeah.
Because graphics is like, oh, I have 15 more years of computing power. Surprise, it looks better. Like, terrible Unity indie games technically have more complex and impressive visuals than stuff from 30 years ago made by the best developers in the world. Because it's just... raw, it's like stock assets and raw, like, default power.